animal source.
Okay, children, what kind of food items we eat? The food we eat from plant source and animal source. Okay, we eat both plant source and animal source. What do animals will eat? If we study minutely, even animal food comes from plants. For example, cow gives us milk. Which eat grass as food, yet which comes from hens, which eats grains as food. Now let us see, what do animals eat? Human beings eat plants like cereals, pulses, vegetables and fruits, as well as animal food like meat, egg, chicken, fish, milk, etc. Thus human beings eat a large variety of food, but animals eat only few types of food. Some animals eat only plant material, while some eat flesh of other animals, whereas some animals eat both plant food as well as flesh of other animals. Next we will see producers and consumers. As we know, plants does not eat food like animals. The green plants can make their own food by the process of photosynthesis in the presence of sunlight and carbon dioxide. Since plant can make their own food, they are called producers. Plants not only make food for themselves, they also provide food for animals and human beings like grains, fruits, vegetables, etc. Animals cannot make their own food and they depend on plants for other animals for food, and hence they are called consumers. Okay, now we discuss what are the feeding habits of animals. Different species of living organisms have different eating habits. Animals eat a variety of food such as plants, seeds, nuts, insects, and the flesh of other animals. Based on their eating habits, animals can be classified broadly into three categories. They are herbivorous, carnivorous, and omnivorous. Along with, we will learn scavengers and decomposers also. Generally, herbivorous will eat only plant, so they are plant-eating animals. Carnivorous animals will eat only flesh, so they are called flesh-eating animals. Omnivorous will eat both plant parts and animal sources, so omnivorous are both flesh and plant-eating animals. The next one is scavengers. Scavengers animals feed mainly on dead and decaying animal and plant matter. And in decomposers, they obtain nutrients by breaking down the remains of dead organic matter. Now we see detailly the eating habit of animals and their special features. First feeding habit animals are herbivorous. Actually, what is herbivorous? It eat only the plants. So animals that eat only plants or plant pods are called herbivorous. The term herbivore is derived from Latin words herba meaning plant and vora meaning to eat. So examples for herbivorous: cows, camels, rabbits, elephants, horses and hippopotamus are some of the herbivorous animals. Now we will see the special features of some herbivorous about the dentition. So dentition means what? It is the arrangement, or you can call it the condition of the teeth in a particular species or an individual. So the teeth are adapted for ripening and grinding the food. And also they have premolars and molars, which is used to break down the plant material into fine particles. In the picture you can clearly see the premolar and molar teeth. They have flat, broad surfaces with many folds. It is used to grind the plant material easily. And also they have sharp incisors to bite off plants, which is not given in the picture. It is in the front of the mouth. That is, it is present in front of the mouth. For better understanding, we will consider human being. When you open our mouth, can you see the upper portion of our teeth? The first four teeth are called incisors. So these teeth are very strong and which is used to bite the plant material. When you bite an apple, you use your first four teeth to bite the apple. The next two teeth are the canines, and the next teeth is the premolars. After that you have a molars. So these premolars and molars are used to chew the food. So I hope now we are clear about where the incisors, canines, premolars and molar teeth are present. For animals, premolars and molars, which is used to break the plant material, and incisors used to bite the plant material. And animals have a small or non-existent can it be? The next feature is about gum pad. Some animals have thick gum pad. For example, cows, buffaloes, goats and sheep, they have a very thick gum pad which is present on the upper portion of their mouth. So this gum pad replaces the incisors in the upper jaw. So where is the incisors present? Which is present in the front side of our mouth, and for animals also. Okay, how they bite the food material? Because they don't have in the upper position any teeth, only they have a gum pad. So they warp their tongues around the grass and use their gum pad along with the teeth in the lower jaw to bite the grass. So like this way, it will bite the food material. And the next one is gut. So what do you mean by gut? In cattle, they chew their food twice in order to break it down completely. Okay, why cattle are chewing their food two times? The reason is because they doesn't have a teeth like us. In upper portion we have a teeth, but it have only the gum buds. So they cannot properly chew the food at one time. So what they will do? They chew their food partly and swallow it. So the partly digested food we called as a gut. So now we understand what is gut. The partly digested food we called as a gut. Does it make the gut? What is happening there? The gut is brought back into the mouth from the stomach. So it will be chewed again. So this act is called chewing the gut. So what it will happen? It softens the food and helps to break down the plant fibers. Now we clear about what is gut and how the cattle is chewing the food. When you keenly notice, cow, buffaloes, goats and sheep, they used to chew their mouth many times. As cattle cannot chew their food at one time like us. For the digestion process, cattle chew their food twice.
The next feeding habit of animal is carnivorous. So carnivorous animals will eat only the flesh of other animals. So animals that eat only flesh of other animals are called what? They are carnivorous. So carni meaning meat, that is the flesh. Vora meaning to eat. So examples for carnivorous are snakes, lions, frogs, eagles, tiger, cheetahs, or some of the carnivorous animals. So now we will see the special features of some carnivorous. Dentition. How dentition is adapted for carnivorous? Dentition in carnivorous is adapted for shearing the flesh of other animals. Also they have a sharp and pointed canines to tear off large pieces of flesh. In the picture you can clearly see the canines teeth. They are very sharp and pointed. And the premolars and molar teeth are carnassial teeth with jagged edges. Jagged meaning that is sharp and uneven. It have a sharp and uneven edges. The picture you can see, it is not clear also. That is like us, it does not have an even edges. So these teeth are well suited to slice the flesh and bones of the prey. And the incisor teeth is present on the front side of the mouth. The name of the animal is jaguar. Generally, jaguars are quick runners. This helps them to catch their prey easily. And also, they have big and strong claws to hold their prey. Claw means it is a curved pointed horny nail which is present on their feet. So, using their strong claws, it easily holds their prey. The next carnivorous animals are eagles and owls. They have sharp eyesight to spot the prey easily. And also they have sharp pointed and curved claws to catch their prey. So they have a curved beaks also. Using that, they can tear the flesh easily. The next carnivore animals are chameleons and frogs. Chameleons and frogs have long and sticky tongues to catch insects easily. Next, we are moving to the third feeding habit of animals, omnivorous. So omnivorous animals eat both plants as well as animals. So animals that eat plants as well as the flesh of other animals are called omnivorous. Omnis meaning all, ora meaning to eat. That is, we eat both plant sources as well as animal sources. Examples for omnivorous are people, bears, pigs, hens, squirrels, dogs, monkeys, rats, and sparrow are some of the omnivorous. Of dentition in omnivorous. So in dentition omnivorous, it is adapted for eating both plants as well as flesh of other animals. us to chew the food. In the picture you can see the first 4 teeth are incisor and next 2 teeth are canines. After that we have a premolars, and after that molar teeth are present there. So the use of incisors to bite, canines to tear the flesh, and premolars and molars is used to chew the food. Next we are going to discuss what are scavengers. So scavengers animals eat the dead and decaying animals and plant matter. So organisms that feed mainly on dead and decaying animal and plant matter are called scavengers. So scavengers keep the ecosystem free of dead animals, because it's eating all the dead animals, so the ecosystem will be clean and neat. You know that carnivorous animals kill other animals and then they take their food. But scavengers, they do not hunt or kill other animals for food. Instead, what they will do, they feed on the already dead animal materials. Vultures, jackals, hyenas, termites, and earthworms are some of the scavengers. This is the picture of vulture which is eating the dead animal matter. This insect name is termites. This animal name is jackal, and this is the hyenas and earthworms. So these are some of the scavengers animals. These they eat only the dead and decaying animal and plant matter. And finally we discuss what are decomposers. So decomposers feed on the remains of other animals. It is a very important role in the ecosystem. By digesting dead matter, they put nutrients back into the soil, making them available to producers. So organisms that obtain nutrients by breaking down the remains of dead organic matter are called decomposers. Fungi and microorganisms such as bacteria are some examples of decomposers. Organisms that are too small to be seen with the naked eye are called microorganisms. This is the picture of bacteria. So in this class we discussed the different feeding habits of animals. They are called herbivorous, carnivorous, omnivorous, scavengers and decomposers. So herbivore will eat only plant and carnivore will eat only flesh of other animals. Omnivorous eat both flesh and plant material. Scavengers have dead and decaying matter, and decomposers obtain nutrients by breaking down the remains of dead organic matter. Thank you, children.